We see the hand of God in the light of creation's grand design, in the lives of those who prove His faithfulness, who walk by faith and not by sight.
What's up, everybody? Good morning, and welcome to the Chester ARP Church Devotional Podcast. You know what we do? We read the Bible. We discuss it. Acts chapter 19, verse 21 is where we are. A riot has occurred in Ephesus because Paul was ministering the good news of Jesus Christ there. Specifically, Luke tells us it was concerning the way of Christ. You know, Christianity was known as the way early on in its life, and that's because Jesus says, "I am the way, the truth, and the life." The Bible teaches us that not only we are to praise God and what we are to believe about God, it teaches us how we are to get to God, and we get to God through the Lord Jesus Christ. And Christians, from their earliest beginnings, have always proclaimed that Jesus Christ is the only way by which we can get to God. And so there is an exclusivity to Christianity by nature. This is the way we are to worship God. This is the way we are to get to God. And people don't like that. They didn't like it in Ephesus. They don't like it in 21st century America. And so we need to make sure we recognize that and understand this exclusivity has always been a part of who God is and always been a part of the church, always been a part of Christianity. It's incredibly inclusive in that what we do is we welcome all peoples to the gospel. So we read yesterday in the Sons of Sceva story and in Ephesus that the Holy Spirit was going forward and people of all kinds were coming to know the Lord Jesus Christ, people, Jews and Gentiles alike, people with different socioeconomic backgrounds, coming to know Jesus. There's an inclusivity in the free offer of the gospel, inclusivity in the opportunity to come to Jesus. But exclusive salvation exists for those who have actually trusted the Lord Jesus Christ. And so that's what we run into here when we come into the story of the riot of the Ephesus, a riot at Ephesus, here in verse 21 of Acts chapter 19. Now, after these events, Paul resolved in the Spirit to pass through Macedonia and Achaia and go to Jerusalem, saying, "After I have been there, I must also see Rome." And having sent into Macedonia two of his helpers, Timothy and Erastus, he himself stayed in Asia for a while. At about that time, there arose no little disturbance concerning the way, for a man named Demetrius, a silversmith, who made silver shrines to Artemis, brought no little business to the craftsmen. These he gathered together. "Men, you know that from this business we have our wealth. And you see and hear that not only in Ephesus, but in almost all of Asia, this Paul has persuaded and turned away a great many people, saying that the gods made with hands are not gods at all. And there is danger not only that this trade of ours may come into disrepute, but also that the temple of the great goddess Artemis may be counted as nothing, and that she may even be deposed from her magnificence, she whom all Asia and the world worship." And when they heard this, they were enraged, and they were crying out, "Great is Artemis of the Ephesians!" So the city was filled with this confusion, and they rushed together into the theater, dragging with them Gaius and Aristarchus and Macedonians who were of Paul's companions in travel. But when Paul wished to go in among the crowd, the disciples would not let him. Even some of the Aristarchs, who were friends of his, sent to him and were urging him not to venture into the theater. Now some cried out one thing and some another, for the assembly was in confusion, and most of them did not know why they had come together. Some of the crowd prompted Alexander, whom the Jews had put forward, and Alexander, motioning with his hand, wanted to make a defense to the crowd. But when they recognized that he was a Jew, for about 2 hours they all cried out with one voice, "Great is Artemis of the Ephesians!" And when the town clerk had quieted the crowd, he said, "Men of Ephesus, who is there who does not know that the city of Ephesus is temple keeper of the great Artemis and of the sacred stone that fell from the sky? Seeing then that these things cannot be denied, You ought to be quiet and do nothing rash, for you have brought these men here who are neither sacrilegious nor blasphemous of our goddess. If therefore Demetrius and the craftsmen with him have a complaint against anyone, the courts are open, and there are proconsuls. Let them bring charges against one another. But if you seek anything further, it shall be settled in a regular assembly. For we really are in danger of being charged with rioting today, since there is no cause that we can give to justify this commotion. And when he had said these things, he dismissed the assembly. It's a wonderful story, but it reminds us of the power of idolatry. Paul and his companions are proclaiming Jesus Christ. People are coming to know Christ and being transformed by the gospel. Their lives are being changed. They're becoming worshipers of the one true God instead of worshipers of Artemis. This naturally impacts the business of idolatry, the business of silversmiths. They create a riot. Notice, though, in this story, the power of the idolatrous belief. We are the people of Artemis. Ephesus, is the place of Artemis. And so this guy is questioning and challenging us. It starts from an economic problem, and then it spreads into the people, and it gets to the heart of their being. That's still how people work. They create riots by having a problem and then starting off and creating a riot by appealing to the emotions of other people. And the crowd gathers together, but finally someone with sense, the clerk of the assembly, quieted the crowd and said, listen, you got to go home. They have not blasphemed. They simply told us about another way. Now, we know that that is the only way. Jesus is the only way. But they simply have told us that there is another way to worship another God. They haven't blasphemed Artemis. They haven't blasphemed our traditions. You guys got to go home. If you want to bring a problem, bring it through the court system as you were. And in the providence of God, people went home. But just think about that for today, that there's only one way to salvation, number one. Number two, people are going to get stirred up when it comes to their idols. The question for all of us is, what are the idols of our own lives? What are the idols of our culture and our society? And when those things are challenged, people's emotions get fired up. And when people's emotions get fired up, it becomes a problem. You guys have a great day. God bless you. I'll catch up with you tomorrow. Be good. Follow Christ. See you soon.